Welcome to the second part of the course, Microwave Spectroscopy. Microwave spectroscopy corresponds to the microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum. We'll start with a brief introduction and then look into the classification of molecules based on their moments of inertia, and then discuss diatomic rigid rotator, angular momentum, selection rule, and we'll end with the discussion about non-rigid rotators. Microwave spectroscopy is also known as rotational spectroscopy, and that is because the rotational energies of molecules lie in the range of the microwave region in the electromagnetic spectrum. And just like vibrational energies, rotational energy of a molecule is also quantized and can be calculated by solving the Schrödinger equations. And a molecule is said to be microwave active only if it has a dipole moment. I repeat, a molecule is said to be microwave active, that is, it absorbs the microwave radiations only if it has a dipole moment. And we assume in our discussions that the rotational and vibrational motions are independent of each other. That is, we consider rotational motion alone without considering vibrational motions. Here, we classify molecules based on their moments of inertia. So you could have a molecule rotating about this axis, or a molecule rotating about this axis. So you can have three perpendicular axes in a 3D space. And based on the values of moments of inertia with respect to these three axes, the molecules can be classified as linear molecules, spherical top, prolate symmetric top, oblate symmetric top, and asymmetric top. Linear molecules like HCl has two of its moments of inertia equal, and the third one equals zero. Spherical top molecules like methane has all three of its moments of inertia equal. Prolate symmetric top molecules has two moments of inertia equal, and that is greater than the third moment of inertia. An example is chloromethane. And we have oblate symmetric top molecules where two of its moments of inertia are equal but lesser than the third moment of inertia. An example is BF3. But most of the molecules we see are asymmetric top molecules where none of its moments of inertia are equal. Examples are anthracene, NO2, and proteins. We'll now consider a diatomic rigid rotator. Well, a rigid rotator is one in which the bond length remains the same. So after calculations, we find that the moment of inertia of a diatomic molecule is given by nu times R0 squared, where nu is the reduced mass given by m1 m2 by m1 plus m2, where m1 and m2 are the masses of the atoms in a molecule, and R0 is the bond length, that is, the distance between the atoms in the molecule. Since the molecule is rotating, it has the rotational kinetic energy, and we obtain the rotational kinetic energy expression by solving the Schrödinger equation. Well, in the rotational kinetic energy expression, we have two new terms, rotational quantum number and rotational constant. And it is given by B times J into J plus 1, and it is expressed in wave numbers, so centimeter inverse. Well, rotational constant is given by H by 8 pi squared I into C, where I is the moment of inertia and C is the speed of light, and it has the same dimensions as wave number. And J is called the rotational quantum number, and it can take values like 0, 1, 2, etc. Now that we know the energy expression, we now draw the diagram showing different energy levels. So we have energy levels 0, 2b, 6b, and so on, corresponding to different J values like 0, 1, 2, and so on. But well, all transitions are not possible. Well, we have a selection rule which says that change in the rotational quantum number equals plus or minus 1 for a transition to take place. So we find the energy difference between the jth energy level and j plus 1th energy level, which comes out to be 2b times j plus 1 in wave numbers. So each of these transitions have values like 2b, 4b, 6b, and so on. And so in the rotational spectrum, we find that the spectral lines are separated by a value of 2b. The number of different directions which an angular momentum vector may take up is limited by a quantum mechanical law, which is stated as, for integral values of rotational quantum number, the angular momentum vector may take up directions such that its component along a given reference direction is either zero or an integral multiple of angular momentum units. And angular momentum unit is equal to h by 2 pi. And the magnitude of angular momentum is given by under root of j into j plus 1 times angular momentum units. And also, each energy level has 2j plus 1 degenerate orientations. For example, j equals 1, We have three different orientations, as you can see in this figure. And we have a reference vertical line. And we also observe that each of these orientations have components value equals plus or minus 1 or equals 0 along the reference line. The intensity of a spectral line is directly proportional to the initial number of molecules in an energy level. So the initial number of molecules in an energy level or population is directly proportional to 2j plus 1 into the exponential you see here. So what we observe is that as the rotational number increases, the population also increases to a maximum and then decreases. So we have a maximum population that happens at j value equals under root kt by 2hcb minus half. Now we discuss non-rigid rotator, that is a molecule in which the bond length is not constant. So we know as the molecule rotates quickly, the atoms in the diatomic molecule tend to move apart due to the centrifugal force. So what we observe in a non-rigid rotator is that the energy difference decreases as the J value increases. And the energy term is given by Ej equals B times J into J plus 1 minus D times J squared into J plus 1 whole squared, where D is the centrifugal distortion constant.